Hello, in this video I will show you how to integrate Prometheus alerts with Slack. Alerts will be generated from Atlassian Jira metrics, and I will follow this tutorial. I will paste a link to this tutorial in the description for this video. Okay, let's start. First, we have to create containers with Jira. I will be using Idalka images. Because it's convenient for me to run Jira with the Postgres database from this image. Okay, all I have to do, I have to copy this contents of the Docker Compose YAML file and create it. But first I will create a folder where I will be doing all, where I will be creating all the files. Okay, now I will move there. Okay, now I can create the Docker Compose.yaml file. Okay, and what's next? Next, I have to put the Docker up. Let's try it. Now Jira is running. Okay, now I will go to my browser and I will run Jira to configure it. It's running on localhost 8080. I'll set up it myself. Next, I will use my own database. These are the settings for the database. The settings of the database are configured in that Docker Compose.yaml file. You can find it there. Test connection. Everything's fine. Next. Okay, now we set up application properties. Everything is correct here. Now we need to provide the license key. Okay, now we will create a new user. It will be an admin user. We will set up email notifications later. Okay, we are in Jira under the admin user. Let's go forward. Skip. And now we have to install the Prometheus for Jira add-on because I also want to get metrics from this add-on. Find new apps, Prometheus, install. Okay, this one is installed. Now we can go to Prometheus exporter settings and have a look if it works. If it works, yeah, it works. Everything is fine, we've got metrics. So everything is done with Jira. Okay, now let's have a look what else we have to do. Now we have to run Prometheus. We need to create a Docker Compose.yaml file. Okay, let's do it. Let's copy it first. And let's go to our folder. Let's create a new window. Okay, let's create first a new folder for Prometheus. And then let's create this Docker Compose file in here. Okay, let's have a look what else we need to do. We need to add this line to the host directory. Next, we need to create the data Prometheus config folder. Okay, let's do it. And we need to create the Prometheus.yaml file. Let's first create this folder. Again, let's move to this folder. And let's create the Prometheus.yaml file. Let's copy it from here. What's going on here? Here we just say that we take the rule files from rules.yaml. We say that we use alert manager. We configure a couple of jobs to take metrics. That's all we do here. Okay. So it's done. What next? Next, we need to create the rules.yaml file. Here we define two rules. The first one is instance down. There will be metric called up. And we look if it equals to zero, it means that the instance is down. And there is also another metric called too many users. This one is Jira all active users gauge. It's from the Prometheus for Jira add-on. And in my case, I put so it shows all license, the number of licensed user in your Jira instance. For example, when it can be useful. For example, you've got the Jira software for 1,000 licenses, and then you added already 998 users, and you want to be notified in this case because you have to do something, because soon you will not have enough licenses for other users. And that's exactly what this alert does. In my case, I put it more than one just to make it easier for me to fire this alert. Okay, let's create this file. Let's copy it. Now, .yaml. Done. What's next? Next, we need to set up our Slack. Okay, let's do it. First, let's open our Slack. That's my Slack. I will create a new channel called Alerts. All alerts will be there. Alerts is done. Skip for now. And next, I have to create a link which to this channel, which will let me put my alerts from Alert Manager of Prometheus to Slack. How to do it? Let's go to the Settings and Administration, Manage Apps. Let's find incoming webhooks. Then I will add it to Slack. Then I will choose the channel, Alerts, Add. And now I've got this link. This one I need to copy. I will need it for this file. See, I need to create a new file, alertmanager.yaml. It's a configuration file for Alert Manager of Prometheus. Okay, let's do it. First, let's create this folder. Let's go to this folder and let's create the file called alertmanager.yaml. Let's copy this one. So basically what's defined here, we've got this Slack API URL which we received a couple of seconds ago. We defined the receiver, and then we defined that everything goes to the channel alerts. And all other things are just configuration for the message, which will be sent to the alerts channel. Okay, let's create the file. It's not done yet. We need to change the link, right? So we need to change this link to the link which we received, the new one. OK. Okay, let's delete it. Let's go here. Then we need to edit here. Okay, what's next? Next, we have to run the Docker. Okay, let's try it. Let's have a look here. Yeah, it's all running, so everything is working, everything is fine. Now it's time to test if the others work. Let's see. First, let's go to Prometheus and have a look if it works correctly. We'll run Prometheus here. Let's have a look at the targets. All are up. Let's have a look at the alerts. Yeah, all our alerts are there. Okay, let's first try to mutate the too many users alert. Okay, let's go to localhost to our Jira. Here it is, our Jira. And let's create a new user. I'll create a new user. It will be a Jira software user. Okay, let's create it. And now we've got two users in our Jira. So basically, the alert must be already firing. Let's have a look at it. First of all, let's go to Prometheus and let's try to get this. Yeah, you see now we've got two alerts. The alert is active. Okay, now let's go to the alert manager. It's over here. Yeah, alert is here. And now we have to wait until we see this alert in Slack. Oh, see, we already have it. Here it is. Okay, here is our alert. So too many users for Jira, too many users, more than one user. Yeah, we've got the message. Now let's delete this user, which we added. In this case, okay, let's delete it first. Delete user. Okay, it's deleted. So in this case, this alert is not valid anymore, right? Because we've got one user. So we will receive a notification in our Slack channel that this issue was resolved. Okay, let's wait for it. But meanwhile, let's see if this one is working correctly. Let's see. Jira active user Gotch. It's one, correct. Alerts. No more alerts anymore. Now let's have a look here. Yeah, no alerts are found. So now let's wait for the result message in our Slack channel. Oh, and we have it here. Let's have a look at it. Okay, now it has a green line here and it's written that the issue is resolved. Very good. Now let's try to mutate another alert. Another alert would be to put our Jira down. Let's put it down. Stop it. Now let's have a look here. No, it's not yet found out that the Jira is down. Let's wait for it. Yeah, now it's down. Yeah, and we've got the message. That's cool. You see, we can see that Jira has been down for more than 1 minute. And that's good. Now, if you put up the Jira instance again, then you will get the resolved message. So everything works. Thank you for watching this video. See you next time. Bye.